In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. That the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning. This Mass is being offered for the intention of Margaret McHugh. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. God, heavenly King, O God, almighty. Let us pray. O God, by who the mystery of today's great feast sanctify your whole church and every people and nation, pour out, we pray, the gifts of the Holy Spirit across the face of the earth, and with the divine grace that was at work when the gospel was first proclaimed, fill now once more the hearts of believers. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the time for Pentecost was fulfilled, they were all in one place together. And suddenly, there came from the sky a noise like a strong driving wind, and it filled the entire house in which they were. Then there appeared to them tongues as of fire, which parted and came to rest on each one of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in different tongues as the Spirit enabled them to proclaim. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven staying in Jerusalem. At this sound, they gathered in a large crowd, but they were confused because each one heard them speaking in his own language. They were astounded, and in amazement they asked, "Are not all these people who are speaking Galileans? Then how does each of us hear them in his native language? We are Parthians, Medes, and Elamites, inhabitants of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and the districts of Libya near Cyrene, as well as travelers from Rome, both Jews and converts to Judaism, Cretans, and Arabs. Yet we hear them speaking in our own tongues of the mighty act of God, the word of the Lord."
Oh, Bless the Lord, O my soul. O Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord. The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they perish and return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit, they are created. And you renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord be glad in his work. Pleasing to him be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, no one can say, Jesus is Lord, except by the Holy Spirit. There are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. As a body is one, though it has many parts, and all the parts of the body, though many, are one body, so also Christ. For in one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slaves or free persons, and we were all given to drink of one Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Come, Holy Spirit, come. And from your celestial home, shed a ray of light divine. Come, Father of the poor, come, source of all our store, come within our bosom shine. You of comforters the best, you soul's most welcome guest, sweet refreshment here below. In our labor rest most sweet, grateful coolness in the heat, solace in the midst of woe. Oh, most blessed light divine, shine within these hearts of yours, and our inmost being fill. Where you are not, we have not, nothing good in deed or thought, nothing free from faint of ill. Heal our wounds, our strength renew, honor, dryness, pour your dew. Wash the stains of guilt away, bend the stubborn heart and will, melt the frozen wall. that go astray, on the faithful who adore and confess you evermore. In your sevenfold gift descend, give them virtue, sure reward. Give them your salvation, Lord. Give them joys that never end. Amen. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said to his disciples, "If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you always. Whoever loves me will keep my word, and my Father will love him. And we will come to him and make our dwelling with him. Those who do not love me do not keep my words. Yet the word you hear is not mine, but that of the Father who sent me. I have told you this while I am with you. The Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I told you. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. I would like to teach you a little bit of sign language this morning, and it is the sign for the concept of Pentecost. It's an easy thing to learn. So as we heard from the reading today in the Acts of the Apostles, you can imagine what it was like. And this is the sign. If you can get your hands up and ready and sign it with me. It starts up here with your fingers wiggling, and then it goes down to your head. Yeah. So this is the sign for Pentecost. And it is meant to symbolize the fire, the flames, Yesterday, we had a beautiful vigil mass here at 4 o'clock, and it was a little bit longer than usual because we had different readings in different languages. We had a language that's spoken in Kenya, in Samoa, in the Philippines, in Bangladesh, and we had, of course, American Sign Language and English, and it was just a beautiful experience to hear all these different languages and see the gospel and see the readings presented in this way. And it really showed the unity of faith. We should remember that the word Catholic means universal. And that doesn't mean that things are done in one way. There's a commonality, there's a shared faith in its diversity. That is what is meant by being Catholic, by having a universal faith. It was beautiful to see that in action yesterday. And also, as I reflect on my time here at St. Jude's, it's been a year and it's gone by so fast. It's hard to believe. But it's been a beautiful thing to see this community develop bonds together as brothers and sisters in Christ. And it's clear that the Holy Spirit is at work among us. We trust the Holy Spirit to lead us in unity, even as we have a diversity of languages here. I remember back in the summer of 2005, my first pilgrimage to World Youth Day in Germany. I got on the plane and I was definitely nervous because I wasn't sure if I would be able to communicate with the German deaf people that I was going to meet there. We didn't share the same language. And there was somebody who was leading the tour in this beautiful city, and it's a deaf school that we were visiting. But I didn't know if I was going to be able to understand them because the German deaf use a different sign language than we do here in America. But we tried to communicate the best we could, and we exchanged signs, and we taught each other, and we picked up little by little, and I was able to understand. We became fast friends on that tour, and we really did become brothers and sisters in Christ. We spent 2 weeks together during that World Youth Day experience, and it was great to see the Holy Spirit at work among us. And that can be true of anyone here, as we have a Pentecost moment. Each of us can have that kind of experience, and we shouldn't be afraid of that. The Holy Spirit does beautiful things at work among us. It was hard for me to leave Germany at the end of that time, because I did feel that bond that we had established, and I didn't want to let go of those new friendships that I had formed. I remember when I was a kid, my parents told me that we would be moving to a new house because my dad had got a promotion with his job. And I remember my dad telling me, you know, Sean, change can be good. I think for many of us, change can oftentimes feel scary and intimidating. But with the Holy Spirit, anything is possible. And we know this is true because God is full of love and goodness. God loves us so much, and that is why he gave us the Holy Spirit to be with us always through his Son, Jesus Christ. Today is the church's birthday, and we celebrate that with the Feast of Pentecost. This is the beginning of the early church and the church that continues to today. Look around you and see, here we are in the church. We occupy this physical space in this building, and we know there are churches all around the world. And that's a symbol of our Catholic universal faith. It's amazing to see how the church has continued in strength through over 2,000 years. The church has survived despite wars, economic challenges, government collapses and turmoil. The church continues and has not fallen. And that is only through the grace of the Holy Spirit. So happy Pentecost, everybody. Please stand. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Father, we offer you our prayers now for our needs and the needs of the world.
For Pope Francis and all the clergy, may the Holy Spirit continue to fill them with grace, strengthen their faith, and guide them in spreading the good news. Let us pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For public officials, may God direct them in just and fair decision-making. Let us pray to the Lord. For those struggling with difficult decisions, may the Holy Spirit fortify their hearts and bring them clarity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in this faith community who are in physical, mental, or emotional pain, may God send his Spirit to comfort them. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, may God welcome them into his heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord. And let us pray in a special way for Margaret McHugh, for whom this Mass is being celebrated. Let us pray to the Lord.
For the community of Uvalde, Texas, which is still mourning the loss of those children and teachers, we pray for their souls to rest in peace and their community to be healed. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For our country in this time of turmoil, may we all look to God, who is the source of light, peace, and love, to help us to be strong in our faith. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Father, we thank you for hearing all of our prayers that we offer you, and we know that you answer them as we seek to do your will. We ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Any creator spirit wounds, meant as to our room, is it all? In bless open a gratia, where to creas de pectora, quid iceris paracletus, donum Dei. Tu septi formis munere, dextre Dei tu digitus, tu rite promissum patris, semone editans gutura. Accende lumen sensibus, infundiamorem cordibus, in fema nostri corporis, virtute firmans pertui. Ostem repellas longitus, pacem que dones potimus, doctore, sicte previo, vite mus omne noxium. Petesiamus da patrem, nos camus a te filium, Deo triusque spiritum, redamus omni tempore. Deo Patris sit gloria, ex filio quia mortuis, surrexit a paracleto, in seculorum secula.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all of his holy church. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that as promised by your Son, the Holy Spirit may reveal to us more abundantly the hidden mystery of this sacrifice and graciously lead us into all truth. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for bringing your Paschal mystery to completion, you bestowed the Holy Spirit today on those you made your adopted children by uniting them to your only begotten Son. This same Spirit, as the Church came to birth, opened to all peoples the knowledge of God and brought together the many languages of the earth in profession of the one faith. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your Church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Margaret McHugh, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Now let us offer each other a sign of peace.
On your stay, we toll is peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On your stay, we toll is peccata mundi, miserere nobis. On your stay.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
righteousness, and let thy righteousness on us descend. Come, Holy Comforter, thy sacred witness bear, in this glad hour, thou who almighty art, now rule in every heart, never from us depart, Spirit of power. To thee, great one in three, eternal praises be, forevermore. Thy sovereign majesty may we and to eternity love and
let us pray. O God, who bestow heavenly gifts upon your church, safeguard, we pray, the grace you have given, that the gift of the Holy Spirit poured out upon her may retain all its force, and that this spiritual food may gain her abundance of eternal redemption. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. A few announcements. The first is that this Friday, we will be having a free movie night, and all are welcome to come. We will be watching an episode of The Chosen. And it's the episode where they show the wedding feast at Cana. It will be closed captioned. And also, we'll be having some Pauline sisters joining us for the movie. This weekend, there will be a book fair as well with the sisters, so please come and buy some books. And then today, after this Mass, there's a raffle ticket going on if you'd like to buy a ticket in the back. There's a table set up, and it is to support it's a 50-50 raffle to support the ICDA conference. So if you win, you will receive half the proceeds, and the other half will benefit our conference that's happening next summer, July 2023, for the International Catholic Deaf Association. So that's in support of that, and we're hosting it here in Boston, which is why we're doing fundraising for it now. And it will be held at the Westin Hotel in the Seaport area of Boston. So it's a great opportunity for us to be able to support the conference to help defray the cost for attendees. So the raffle tickets will be on sale immediately following this mass. One ticket is $5, three tickets for 10. Good luck. I hope you win. And we have our youth ministry tonight, our meeting at 6 o'clock in the parking lot. We had a great car wash yesterday, which was a good success and a lot of fun from what I hear. So thank you for your support of that. And then choir practice is on Tuesday evening from 7 to 8 p.m. So any more announcements, please see the bulletin. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May God, the Father of lights, who was pleased to enlighten the disciples' minds by the outpouring of the Spirit, the Paraclete, grant you gladness by his blessing and make you always abound with the gifts of the same Spirit. Amen. May the wondrous flame that appeared above the disciples powerfully cleanse your hearts from every evil and pervade them with its purifying light. Amen. And may God, who has been pleased to unite many tongues in the profession of one faith, give you perseverance in that same faith, and by believing, may you journey from hope to clear vision. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you. Amen. Go forth, the Mass is ended. Thanks be to God. Amen.